Welcome everyone to this third video about the solution of nonlinear equations using open methods. In the previous videos, we introduced the Newton-Raphson method and the Newton-Raphson algorithm. In this video, we are going to present a simple example to demonstrate how Newton-Raphson method works. Let's start with the relationship or the function f of x is equal to e to the minus x minus 1/2. This is a nonlinear equation or a nonlinear function. If we try to find the root, it will probably not come directly. We'll rather get the root using a logarithm of the 0.5. Anyway, if we start with an initial guess of minus 1 and try to apply the Newton-Raphson method, let's say here we have f of minus 1 will be 2.22, while f prime, the slope at minus 1, is minus 2.7. Remember, this is exactly the same function that we used in the bracketing methods to demonstrate the methods as well. And we know that the solution. So let's continue. Now to find the second guess or the first evaluation will be the initial guess minus f over f prime, and that will give us a minus 0.183. Now we use it again, repeating the same process, evaluating the function at the new guess and the slope at the new guess, and then use them to get x2, and so on. We will repeat this a few times. If you remember, in the bracketing methods, it needed about 14 iterations to get to the solution. For this problem, as a matter of fact, we will only need 5 to 6 iterations to get to the solution. You'll find that the 5th and 6th solutions are exactly the same number. So we reduced the number of iterations by 66%, or almost that. There is some mathematical analysis that can give us a prediction of the relative number of iterations needed by each method. Again, I'm avoiding all this just to show you how the method works. The modification of the methods and creating new methods will probably be introduced in a second course in numerical analysis, not the first course in numerical analysis. Now let's have a look on the program that uses the Newton-Raphson method to demonstrate how it really works with us. As you can see here, this program is actually published already on GitHub. As in all my programs, I prefer to clear everything before starting, just to get myself easily going through the program. Then my initial guess is a minus 1, and the tolerance I'm having is 1/1000, and the number of iterations is 20, initializing the counter and initializing the error in order to avoid any problems. Now here is the main loop, the body of the iterations. It starts with an infinite loop while true. While true is a loop that will go forever unless we use a break function in it. All these methods work on Octave here, written on Octave, but it works just fine as is on Matlab or Freemat. I prefer to use open source software anyway. Now I increment the counter, started with a 0, so now it's 1. I go to evaluate the f of x and the slope, f prime of x, as you can see here. This is the derivative of that function. I get the second best or the second value by using the Newton-Raphson method, which is x2 or x1 equals to x2 equals x1 minus f1 over f1 prime. Now comes the evaluation of the error. Just in case x2 is 0, which is quite rare to happen, if at all, I check if it is not zero, then the relative error is the change x2 minus x1 over the new one. I always assume that the new solution is better than the old solution, so it's a better approximation to the exact value. If you are unlucky and the x2 is equal to zero, then the error is measured by the difference between the two values. This usually doesn't happen, and I don't have to put a lot of load on it right now. I'm checking whether I'm going to end the loop or not. If the function is zero, if you're extremely lucky, then done, break, you're okay. If it's not, then is the error less than the tolerance? If yes, again, break. If the error is not less than the tolerance, then we check whether the counter, the number of iterations, exceeded the maximum number of iterations or not. If not, if yes, then we break again. If all this is not true, then we put the new value in the old value and continue our loop, get back to the beginning of the loop. When we break, there you go, you get the results given here. Let's just see how this is done. If I run it here, I get the different values of f1 prime, x2, f1, f1 prime, x2. Of course, I can remove all this, but you can see here how quickly it converges. It starts with, we started with a minus 1, now it's minus 1, minus 0.8, 0.18. Following that, it gets to 0.4, then following that gets to 0.654, 0.692, 0.693315. This is actually the number that we converge on, because here the last iteration it got exactly the same number we are talking about. So as you can see here, we already converged in 5 iterations. The 6th was good for us, just to see that we converged, and this program works with many functions. If you just replace f here to get and f prime to get the new values. Usually we use a function that's inside, we use a function in computer terms. We create a function, separate function, for which we send the values of x to give us back the values of f1. We'll see that when we try to use Newton-Raphson method in multidimensional problems. So now I hope this was a clear presentation. I hope it's understood. If not, I would love to see your comments on the video to be able to answer your questions. I'm always willing to do that. In the next video, we will present the secant method. As you probably have noticed, the Newton-Raphson method depends a lot on the slope of the function. In some problems, we are unable to evaluate the slope. In those cases, which are not really few, there are so many, the secant method becomes more handy, since it doesn't need the slope of the function at the guess we have. So I hope to see you next video with the secant method.